Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is meant by radius of gyration. The next definition. Radius of gyration is defined as that distance from a given axis up to a point where the entire area is assumed to be concentrated. So here I have written the definition of radius of gyration, that it is defined as that distance from a given axis up to a point where the entire area is assumed to be concentrated. To understand this in a better manner, we require a diagram. Suppose we have an arbitrary area which is called as total area, capital A. Now within this total area, if we have small areas, like I am assuming here three areas, A1, A2 and A3. Now when I see their distances, A1, A2 and A3. So I'll mark their distances. The distance of A1 with respect to x-axis, this will be y1. Distance of A2, distance of A3, y3. So here we have three individual areas. I am assuming that there are three areas. Like this, we would be having n number of areas in the total area capital A. So A1 is at distance y1, A2 is at y2 and A3 is at y3. Now, if for this example, I am considering that the entire area is in the form of strip, and the distance of this strip with respect to x-axis this is k. So now here, if the total area is capital A, and if I am taking the moment of this area about x-axis, so I'll write down, therefore moment of area about x-axis is given by Ixx is equal to, the moment is area into distance, so I am taking the moment of area into distance. Now again taking the moment of area about x-axis. Now if I am taking the moment second time, it becomes Ixx is equal to A into, that distance will become distance square. So Ixx is equal to Ak square. So from this I will get k is equal to root of Ixx upon capital A. So this, I will keep this as equation number 1, and I can say that therefore k is equal to radius of gyration about x-axis. So here, as I have written in the definition, that radius of gyration is defined as the distance, as that distance from a given axis, that is x-axis here, up to a point where the entire area is assumed to be concentrated. So here I am assuming the entire area is concentrated at this point, and previously the area was distributed throughout. So the area, common area, denoted by capital A, it is at a distance of k. So this k is nothing but it is called as radius of gyration. So here I have written the formula, it is root of Ixx upon area. Next, similarly, I can say that moment of area about y-axis is given by Iyy is equal to area into k, and similarly for that I'll say that therefore again taking the moment of area about y-axis, for that also I need to have a diagram where I can explain it. So here again I am assuming a body of irregular shape which has total area capital A. Inside this we have three different areas now. I'll say that this is area 1, area 2 and area 3. They are distances with respect to y-axis. The first distance is of area 1, that is here I have, this is of area 2, so x2. For area 1 it is area 1, I'll denote it as area 1, so here I have x1, this is area 2, so x2, and here I have x3. Now similarly I can assume that this total area is in the form of a strip, and that total area with respect to y-axis, its distance we will call that as k. So now when I'm again taking the moment of area about the y-axis by taking distance x, that will become Iyy is equal to a into, it was k, so it becomes k square. So now from this I can say that therefore k is equal to root of Iyy upon area. So previously in equation number 1 I had got the radius of gyration about x-axis. Now I'll keep this as equation number 2nd, and where k is equal to radius of gyration about y-axis and its unit, since it is radius, its unit will be either in terms of mm, it can be in terms of centimeter, or it can be in terms of meter. So here in this video, we have seen the definition and concept behind radius of gyration.